Hello, we have a gorgeous rainy spring day, and my goats have been off of my pasture for about a month. They've been in their pen areas, and I just wanted my pastures to kind of take hold and get that nice spring push of grass. And it's about 8 inches, maybe a little bit longer. So yesterday we let them out for the first time. They were super stoked. Hello, guys. And then today, with the rain, they weren't too sure they wanted to be out here, but they do, and they're doing good. So my three black goats, Jezebel, Carlos, and Moonshine. This is Jezebel. I hope you can see. They're coming in with red legs this year. They were solid black last year, but look at that. Jezebel has the most classic alpine markings. And, but her legs, so from her underbelly down, you can see black on top, red legs. She's going to be stunning. Carlos, who was jet black last year, let's see, he is also coming out with red legs. And Moonshine, who is my black and white, is also coming up with red legs. Everyone's changing colors this year. And look at Hobbs. He was my all red one last year, my chamois. And he's getting kind of a blonde middle section. So his color, all of them are changing. Easy's getting just a little more white. Absinthe has stayed the same. Everyone came out of winter so beautiful, so conditioned. Tangle and Moonshine are still blowing their woolly winter coat. But they are so happy to be on pasture. And we went through a kind of, well, what I would consider a frightful thing. Carlos pulled up lame on his back right. And I couldn't identify what it was, but it was definitely swollen right above his hoof. I did hoof trimming. I smelled. There was no foul smell. So I ruled out scald and hoof rot, which I don't think are common here anyway. And with the way we keep our goat yards, it would be really difficult for them to get either of those. He's not had any parasite issues in any kind of way. Look how happy my ladies are. And so I went and did a full hoof trimming 2 days in a row just to try to see if it was a rock caught or wedged in there, if in between his claws there was something. And it looked like it could have been an injury, like maybe he was stepped on or was getting bashed by the bigger boys and like rolled on something. I'm not quite sure. It's definitely not broken, but it's tender when I palpate it. But there was a little cut in between his claws. And so I flushed that with triodine. And he was very, very sensitive to that. And so I'm hoping that that's what was causing him to be a little bit lame. He was still eating. He was moving around, but he was really tender. So we had to separate him from the big guys. And he appreciated that, actually. He looked forward to that. Let me see if I can move over this way. I love watching my goats graze. And this rain has just been a gift, a total, total gift. But when they get spunky, they take off and they run to the back gate. We call it the hot lava game. They run and then I call them and they come back and then they run and I call them and then they come back. If we get a walker or a biker go by, they'll do it for sure. But they haven't been up here for a whole month. Everyone's looking good. Okay, have a great day. We're getting our quail set up ready. We've got 70 quail. Here we go. Let's see. Here we go. Yeah. Easy, easy. Easy peasy ham and cheesy. He's such a nice goat. Such a nice goat. And Carlos still has the most incredible coat out of all my goats. But we have our trailers fully registered now. We're just doing some modifications on it for the goats and waiting for Carlos to heal up, and then we're taking him out. We've been researching new areas, new maps, new everything, and I'm so excited to see new areas. Look how lovely Moonshine's coat is. So, so nice. Okay. You guys have a good day up here.